So awesome. All right, so the revoke cryo comes in three different cases, right?
Right.
The first case, these are basically your risers. There's six of them that come with the package. And this allow us to elevate the user, okay? And then, of course, we've got the two main cases. And these are Pelican flight cases that can go on the airplane. They're about 70 pounds each, okay? When I travel with these, I can check them into as a regular baggage into an airplane, go to my next location, order the nitrogen at the event, and then roll them in, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you how easy it is to set this up. The first case has the chamber itself, has a diffuser, and then the blower. And then in this case is the controller, right? So I'll initially take that with the controller. Controller has two different valves. One goes to the nitrogen, and then the other one goes to the chamber. And then this one is for the thermocouple to measure the temperature and to run the diffuser inside the tank. And of course, a power. All right, so I usually set that up over on this side. Take out, the unit comes with two hoses, two basic hoses, like this. One to go to the nitrogen tank, and then the other one to go to the chamber. I carry one of these to insulate it if I need to as well. And then a power strip comes with the Reva. In the other case, this is a hose that goes from the blower to the chamber. Set that aside. The diffuser will go inside the chamber. And what this does is it takes the liquid nitrogen gas vapors from there and it distributes it into the unit. But inside of here is a thermocouple right inside there that measures the temperature. And like I mentioned, the blower is right here. And then the power cords, right? And of course, this is the chamber itself. Now the chamber, this one is made out of military grade, aerospace grade. They use the same material in nuclear power plants for shielding material. Mm-hmm. If you look on the space shuttle, the satellites are covered with this. So it can handle the extreme temperatures that we're looking for. So it's no joke. There's about an 11-year shelf life on this material.
11 years.
Yeah. So that's basically everything that comes in the case. So I'll just stack these up. Out of the way, and then I get this thing going. So the first thing I do is I look for the bottom of the machine, which is right there. This is the hose where the blower hose goes into. I go ahead and try to close that up first. The beauty of this is it fits any kind of fitness environment, right? It's very rugged, like Normatex. Mm-hmm. The downside, of course, is it has a blower, right? There, you're gonna hear some noise, and it's not sexy like all the other machines, but it does what it needs to do, and that's really what's important. So I attach this side to the blower itself. Thank you.
take this diffuser right here, and we first put the hose through. This is one hose, right through that hole. Go ahead and attach it here. Usually you'll take a wrench and just tighten it one notch and you're good. And then I'll feed this wire back through that hole. We then attach it back here to this Velcro. Take this sleeve. And attach it here. What that does is it allows the nitrogen to come in and distribute around the machine. Okay? Attach it to the back. Take this hose. Attach it to that. It's the power cable. Attach this power cable to the back. And attach the temperature thermocouple to the back here as well. All that's set up, I then attach this to the connection in the back. Right there. So that's the only two things that you have coming out the back. And then powers up here, and then this goes into the liquid part of the nitrogen. Now you see I can hand tighten that, but I'll usually take a wrench and just do one quick turn. Okay? Once I had it all set up, I like to just keep the cables all nice and clean, free of touching all that. And then set it up however you want it. And then you turn the power on. The power is simple. The control panel basically has an on and off switch, maximum cryo temperature, so it can go from zero all the way up to 300 degrees Fahrenheit, and time can go from zero all the way to 3 minutes. It's that simple. To run the system, basically once the body is full to the top with a graphite, it means it's cold enough to start the machine. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the liquid nitrogen on. You can hear the, all of a sudden the nitrogen come through, right? I'm going to press the on button. I will hear the valve open up, and now it's sucking the nitrogen through. Right away,
the nitrogen start to cool off right here.
You're probably seeing a little bit there. Now, if you count the time, one of the immediate issues that people ask is how long does it take to cool?
As you can see, our temperature is dropping quite fast.
We're already down to 10 degrees. Take a look at the nitrogen coming out. What I'll do is I'll close this up to secure the nitrogen in the cabin to allow it to build up. Our temperature is dropping real quick. As you can see, the body's filling up with the nitrogen. At this point, at negative 80 degrees, I can get the user started changing out and preparing them. They're ready to go in at this point. So in less than 3 minutes, we were able to cool up the machine just enough to get someone in there right now. So however long that was, that's how quickly we can get set up with the Revo 5.